straps. So this is inseams. I'll do that one second. This is waistbands. This one I did already. I will press it afterwards and straighten it out a little bit. But what I do, because I open them up and take the pants off, so I stitch this. I'm going to end up cutting this off. Sometimes I use those for something. So I'm just going all the way down and stitching that back together. I'll tuck things in. I don't take all the extra pieces off. Sometimes I'll take these off, but right now I feel like keeping them on. I'm having a little bit of trouble with my thread breaking. I think I have the wrong needle for my fabric. I don't want to change it right now. I'm being lazy. Trouble with the stretch, and I will try to not have to deal with that right now. And because I find that it lays better if I also stitch along the other side, I stitch along the other side. And incorporate the frame from my jeans into my project. Oh, this machine is loud because it has a, what do you call it? Not a servo, a clutch motor. Okay. I think 22 inches is what I measure straps if I make them. So here's my bag. I have to locate my... Here's one of my marks. So I mark it here, and I see one here. Right there. And I mark it here. I put my strap. Inside, right side down. So that's my right side. Okay, I have to make sure that it is flat. And here's my other one, inside of my notch. Fraying is natural in used jeans. You can either fight it or embrace it. I choose to embrace it. The rest of the strap is good enough, so it gives it character. Okay, my straps are on, and I'm going to fold it over. I think it's about an inch, what I'm doing. So I start at this pocket spot because this is the most complicated spot, and I'm going to put my tag here. This light messes with the camera. I go back and I reinforce the straps. I will fix all of my strings. That is a finished bag. It is a soft-sided bag. It rolls up nice, so you could put it into your bag and then use it shopping or at a farmer's market. Okay, the other way that I do this is with the inseam. I only use it when it's an actual flat felt seam. So here's right in the middle of the inseam. I cut out that big knot. And then I make them the same length, whatever that length is. That's what my bag is. And I do it the same way as I do the other one. Stitch one. So I think it can go either way as long as I do it the same. I put it to the inside of my line. the other side. Fold it down about an inch, and I start where the pocket is because I feel like that's the most troubled spot. And that's approximately an inch, as long as I do it the same ish. I really think that this light messes with the camera above, but it's a fight between who gets to see. Side, but it's okay. Something doesn't like my fabric, or my needle's not completely straight, but you can see it works for a while, and I don't feel like changing my needle. Really is hard to thread a needle under pressure, but at least I get to get this strap out of the way now. I will go over to the iron and press this nice and neat. Go back over it and give these an extra stitch. Thank you. go. Nice market bag with a pocket.